creating custom subtitles, generating closed captions, and transcribing your footage all within Premiere Pro is super simple, way easier than you might think. I'm Tom from Envato Tuts Plus. I've got about a decade's worth of post-production and editing experience, and I'm going to show you how to do all of that and a little bit more right now. Now, this video is of course brought to you by Envato Elements, which is a super simple to use subscription service that gives you access to unlimited downloads of millions of assets. And I'm talking stock footage, photos, music, fonts, video templates, presets for photo, like there's so much on there. Go and check it out. And if you haven't already, check out the link in the description below to have a look at Envato Elements today. So the first thing we've obviously got to do is open up Premiere Pro. So let's do that right now. So when you undertake this step, you'll already be at the end of your process. So go ahead and open up your timeline that you want to create your captions and subtitles for. For me, I'm just going to use this video that I recently completed for the Envato Tuts Plus YouTube channel. It's DaVinci Resolve Color Grading for Beginners. You can watch that right now. Get subscribed to the Envato Tuts Plus YouTube channel, the one that you're watching this video on right now, so you don't miss out on more of this great content. You can watch this full color grading video that I've made on the Envato Tuts Plus YouTube channel right now. I take you through for a full hour how to use the color grading tools in DaVinci Resolve. And if you've never used the program before, it's a perfect way to start. I show you all that you need to know to get started with color correction and color grading in DaVinci Resolve. Make sure you go and check it out right now. Or better yet, wait till this video is finished, then go check it out. There'll be a link in the description below. But anyway, let's get back to the purpose of this video. I'm going to pick just a little moment in here that we can do our caption for. Obviously, we don't need to do an entire full hour of closed captioning for the purpose of this quick tutorial. So I'm just going to grab this little section here. Let's turn this off mute so you can hear what I'm saying. If you've never used DaVinci Resolve before, don't worry, I'll go through everything that you need to know. And if you have used it before and you are familiar with the program, hopefully you can pick up a few tips and tricks along the way. So there we go. That's a little moment. I'm going to delete the rest of this so that we can just work with that little piece of footage. Going to click on the piece of footage here that we want to make the subtitles for and go over to the captions and graphics tab at the top of Premiere Pro here. Now you can see up in the left-hand side here, you've got your usual things like effects controls, you've got your Lumetri scopes, but what we're looking at today is the text function just here. Now it gives you a few options. You can transcribe the sequence, you can create a new captions track, or you can import captions from a file. So if you do have an SRT file that you just want to pull in and drop onto your footage, this is where you can do so. And this might be if you've had it transcribed, translated, and made into captions via a third party, or just another editor or assistant that you're working with. That's where you would import your captions from a file. Now, what we can do, if we want to do this manually, we can create a new captions track. So we'll do that right now. Format, subtitle. There's obviously different versions of this here. I would stick to just the subtitle one here. If you know specifically that you need to use the Australian OP47 standard, the CEA 608, the CEA 708, or the EBU subtitle standard, or teletext, then you can go ahead and use those. If you don't know if you need to use those, you can go and research those, but for the most part, these are for broadcast use. And if you are creating captions and subtitles that need to be in these broadcast standards, then I assume that you actually already know that. So go ahead and just tick subtitle for now. Now this section here, style, I only have the option to do none because I have not currently saved any styles in Premiere. Once you save some styles in Premiere, you can drop it down from here. For the moment, we're just gonna hit subtitle and style none, hit okay. And once I've done that, you can see it's added a little subtitle track at the top of your timeline. Right here, you can see show all captions track, hide all captions tracks, show active captions track only. If I hide that there, it goes away. If I show all captions track, it's there. Now, how do I create a caption here? Well, I can just drag my playhead to the start and hit spacebar to hear what I'm about to say. If you've never used DaVinci Resolve before, so that first line is if you've never used DaVinci Resolve before. Drag my playhead back to here and I hit the plus button up here to add a new caption segment. So again, I said, if you've never used DaVinci Resolve before, don't need to capitalize that. There you go, that's added the caption there. And you can see in this section here, I've added a caption. Gonna drag it back to the start and play through. If you've never used DaVinci Resolve before, don't worry, I'll go through everything. And you can see that I say something else while that caption's still up. So click on here. DaVinci Resolve before, don't. DaVinci Resolve before. That's where it ends. So I can just simply drag that caption file back to there. If you've never used DaVinci Resolve before, don't worry. And you can see I could then go on and do the next one here, add a new one with the playhead. Don't worry, and so on. But there's actually a much easier way to do this. So I'm going to delete these for now, and we're going to zoom out here and start again. I'll just click on the file here, but if I go up to transcript, that's where we can create a new transcription. And you'll notice this was what was in our original window when we first went to the text panel here in our timeline. So if I go to transcript and I go create transcription, it's going to ask me here a few different things. So it's going to ask us which audio track we want it to listen to build our transcription from. So for me, I've only got one track of audio in here, so I will do it on mix. If I had multiple tracks here and say I just wanted it to be on track one, I could do track one or track two, track three, and so on. Right now, we're going to leave it as mix. Now you can do transcribe to in and out point only. So if I had an in and out point like that, then it would transcribe just that section. But we're not going to do that. We're going to do this whole piece here. So we'll go back into here. Transcribe in and out point only. We'll leave that unchecked. Recognize when different speakers are talking. That's really handy if you have multiple people in your transcription. We're not going to tick it for now because it's just me. So I'm going to hit transcribe and we'll see what happens. You can see on the left over here, it's doing things in the background. And it doesn't take very long at all, obviously depending on how long your piece of footage is. So right now you can see that it's come up. First of all, you can see it says unknown. And you know how before I said you can tick that box to make sure it can recognize different speakers? Well, this is where you can edit those speakers. So it's just me, so I know it's just me talking, but if you hit edit speakers, you can change this to Tom. Now let's play it along and we'll make sure as this highlights along here that everything is correct. This is where we can have a chance to correct anything that the AI may have gotten wrong. If you've never used DaVinci Resolve before, don't worry, I'll go through everything that you need to know. Obviously, there's a mistake there. If you've never used a ring to resolve before, that's not what we're after. So I'll just double click on here. If you've never used DaVinci, Resolve before, don't worry. Now let's play that back again. If you've never used DaVinci Resolve before, don't worry, I'll go through everything. And that should be a comma there. Don't worry, I'll go through. And obviously that last one there is incorrect as well. So that should be the color page in DaVinci Resolve. Where all the tools are and generally how to use them. Now you can either do that correction step here, as I've just done, or in the next step once you've created the captions as well. Just depends on how long your video is, what your workflow is, and kind of where you like to do those corrections. It's up to you. So I'll hit create captions now and we'll see what happens. Okay, so it gives us the options here to create from sequence transcript, which is what we've just done, or create a blank track, which is what we were doing earlier. We'll check create from sequence transcript. Again, subtitle default here is what we're going to stick to. Like I said before, if you know that you need to use any of these standards, please go ahead and use those. But for us, we're just going to stick with subtitle default. Format, subtitle. Again, it's the same thing. Stream, don't worry about that. Can't do anything there. Style, none. Leave all of this as it comes up when you hit subtitle default. And choose if you want single or double lines. For me, I'm happy with double lines. I find it is easier to read if you've got more of the text centered in the screen rather than having to read very far from the left of frame to very far from the right of frame, but it's up to you. So now that I've hit that, it's creating captions and you can see in the timeline, it has dropped those captions like we had before into a new subtitle stream here. This first one now that is toggled inactive was that first one that we made originally. You can right click on that and delete track if you don't want it there. Now, if I drag my playhead to the start, we know all of these subtitles will be correct because we've just made those corrections before. But if you did want to change any, you can double click in here and you can change anything along the way. But let's watch and see how it's come up. If you've never used DaVinci Resolve before, don't worry, I'll go through everything that you need to know. And if you have used it before and you are familiar with the program, hopefully you can pick up a few tips and tricks along the way. So you'll notice one thing that didn't come through from when we changed before is this comma at the end of don't worry, instead of a full stop. So I'm just going to double click into here, change that to a comma, and there we go. You can see it's automatically updated in our program window over here. So if you click on your subtitles over here, you can change all of your styling the same way that you would change any text in Premiere Pro. If I just grab the text tool here and just write something, you'll see you get the same parameters that you can change over here in the Essential Graphics tab. So if you're used to working with text in Premiere Pro, this will be super simple for you. We'll delete that for now. So clicking back onto our subtitle layer over here, you can see all of the different changes that we can make. This is where you can download your track styles. So you can change all of this over here and then you can hit create style based on what you've got here so that you can reuse it for later on. It could be, you know, YouTube style or Instagram style, depending on how you like to change it up for each platform. For me right now, I'm just going to change the font. So I'll click on this track here and I'll just change to something different. I'm going to change it to Noir Pro. There we go. You can see that one has changed to Noir Pro. But if I click through, this one here is still in the default. So how do I change these all at the same time? I'll go back to this one and I'll do Command Z to undo that font change. And I will highlight all of these at once and then I'll change to Noir Pro. And now you can see that all of these have been changed to the font that I want. Now, what else can you do to make some stylistic changes? Let's say I want DaVinci Resolve to really stand out as I'm saying things. Making sure I've got the selection tool enabled, not the text tool. If I double click on this layer here, highlight just DaVinci Resolve, and then I go to fill, I can change it to any color. So let's change this to a nice golden yellow color that's going to stand out. Okay, there we go. So now you can see DaVinci Resolve, just those words have been highlighted. So if we also want to change the other time we say DaVinci Resolve in this, we can just click through to where we know it already is. I think it's in this one. Or if we are over here going, all right, well, we want to change DaVinci Resolve to be yellow. Up in this section over here, we can hit search and I'm just going to search DaVinci. And you'll see there it's highlighted twice and we know that we've made that one already. We can click down into this one. It's going to take us automatically over to this subtitle section here. We can double click on here, highlight DaVinci Resolve, and we can make it that same color. But we want to make sure it's exactly the same color. So let's go back over to this one here. Highlight our DaVinci Resolve bit here. You can see the colors come up. Double click on this, highlight it. Command C or Control if you're on a PC. We come back over to this section. Double click on our DaVinci Resolve here. Go to fill and then paste that code into there. And now we've got the words DaVinci Resolve colored in yellow throughout. Perfect. So now that we've finished that, we need to export our files. So I'm just going to highlight my in and out points here. I'm going to hit Command M and we bring up the export settings page. Now you'll be used to seeing things like video and audio and working with all of your sequence settings and export settings up here. I suggest we find a place to export these and make sure all of our render settings are correct. Just leave use maximum render quality on. I have another video about this. If you do want to check out when to use maximum render quality, check it out on Envato Tuts Plus YouTube channel. And for the sake of this one, we're just going to keep it as a VBR one pass. Now, instead of going to queue or export right now, I'm going to go over to the captions tab just here. Now, this gives us export options for our captions. We can either burn the captions into the video, and that means to keep them on screen no matter what. They're actually part of the video now, the same way that any of our titles or graphic sequences will be part of the video. Or we can create a sidecar file. And that means that it will export the video and it will export a specific subtitle file as well, or an SRT. Or we can just do none. So if you do need to just do a non-subtitled version of this video, you can do that here. And then later on, when you do need to export your subtitle file, you can do that there. You can include subtitle styling, so that's the colored DaVinci Resolve that we just did then. And if the program or service that you're using to add that subtitle file to will support the different styling that you've got in your SRT, it will do that. If not, it will just default to its standard, which will be white text with a gray drop shadow. So we'll do two versions. We'll burn the captions into the video. And this one, I'm just going to rename this so that we know which one is which. So I'm going to just add a little burn in here. All right, so now we'll hit export. So that has successfully exported. We'll find that here and you'll see it's burnt in. If you've never used DaVinci Resolve before, don't worry. And that's including our colored version of DaVinci Resolve there. Now, if we want to do just the sidecar file, let's do that there. And we'll also just keep it in the same spot. We'll keep it as how to add subtitles V0101. We're not going to call it burn in because we're not burning in this time. So we'll hit export. And that's created the video without the subtitle. And it's created the SRT subtitle file here as well. And it's based the name on our video. So we know that it will match up exactly. How to add subtitles V0101 MP4.SRT. How to add subtitles V0101.MP4. Now, how do we use those? All right, let's go to somewhere like YouTube and we go select files to upload. So this is the one without the burn-in. We'll open that up. Now I'm going to skip a few things on here because we're not really uploading this one. I'm just showing you how to do it. We do need to select the video language here in order to be able to add the subtitle files. So I'm going to go down here and make sure the English is checked. And now I'll go over to the next page here on video elements. You can add subtitles. So I'll hit add. So I'll hit upload file here and I'll do it with timing. Continue, select our .srt file. And there we go. Now, because when we exported this sidecar file, we did check include SRT styling, you can see here that it's tried to add the color for DaVinci Resolve. And let's play through and see if this actually worked. Spoiler alert, it doesn't. So YouTube doesn't support this in its closed captioning. So therefore we don't get that color coming through. Now, if you had a heap of styling in here that you wanted to bring through and you were going to have to change a lot, I would suggest going back to Premiere, unchecking that and then rendering that sidecar file out. However, for our purpose, what we can do here is we can just delete the styling that it's tried to add from this section. And we know it's down here as well. And then we're all good. So I'll play this through and we'll make sure it's worked. If you've never used DaVinci Resolve before, don't worry, I'll go through everything that you need to know. And if you have used it before and you are familiar with the program, hopefully you can pick up a few tips and tricks along the way. So that's worked, so I'll hit done, I'll hit next. All the checks are good, I'll hit next. And for the time being, I'm just going to make this private so only I can see it. And then I'll show you exactly how that looks to the end user. So hit save here. And if we go to that video, if you've never used DaVinci Resolve before, don't worry. Where are the captions? Well, the captions are hidden down here. This is why we've done it as a sidecar file and not as a burnt in. So now the user has the option to toggle those captions on or off. And these are the captions that we have just made in Premiere Pro. And it's as simple as that. We've just made custom subtitles to burn into our video. We've generated closed captions for things like YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, whatever it is that you need to put your video online and you want some closed captions. And we've used a great AI tool all within Premiere Pro to auto transcribe our sequences into text. It's mind blowing how much better this system is than it was even 2, 3, 4 years ago. It used to be a lot more of a hassle for those of us who were using Premiere Pro, back in the dark ages. Now this video is of course brought to you by Envato Elements, which is a super easy to use subscription service that gives you access to millions of digital assets and you get to download all of those unlimited. You can use them all in your projects right away. And I'm talking stock footage, photos, music, sound effects, fonts, video presets. There's just so much on there. Go and check it out. And if you haven't, there's a link in the description below.